Tennis 34, Donna Fagel, Coming Cat, and starring Buck Owens and Roy Clark. Grandpa Jones, Canola Huckabee, Junior Salkin, Jordy Tapp, Lisa Todd, Don Heron, Winnie Burrow, Spring Bean, Harvey Redford, Annie Randall, The Hager, Misty Roll, Mary Ann Gordon, Riddle and Phelps, Master Magician, Beauregard, Kathy Baker.
All week long we've been working hard.
Fishing and sleeping, and boy, we're tired.
We ought to help Junior with his Mountain Dew.
Well, we've got a hee-haw show to do.
The road by any other name would still smell the same. Christianity by any other name would be a lot easier to say.
Now here's Roy Clark and the whole hee-haw gang.
Stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Like a blind man, I wandered alone. Worries and fears I claimed for my own. Then, like a blind man, that God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Stealing lingerie?
No! What happened?
They let her go because it was her first slip.
You can't judge a woman by her clothes today. There's just too little evidence.
Hey, Annie, I met a man at the recreation hall on Saturday night, and we played ping pong. Ooh, boy, did we have fun.
I didn't know ping pong was that much fun.
Oh, yeah, I'd miss the ball and we'd both chase it under the table. Then he'd miss the ball and we'd both chase it under the table.
Well, where does all the fun come in?
Why, silly, under the table.
Grandpa, I'm looking for excitement, I'm looking for beautiful women, and I'm looking for adventure. Don't try to stop me, I'm on my way.
Oh, who's trying to stop you? I want to go eat.
If I'd pose for him in a bikini.
Of course you told him you're not a model.
Of course, but he said that doesn't matter because he's not an artist.
Doc, can you give me a formula for a good speech?
Yep, have a good beginning and have a good ending and keep them both close together.
Right.
I wish they'd stuff some of this straw in my ears and then I couldn't hear these jokes.
Oh, doctor, 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 you gotta come and help my buddy.
What happened to him?
Oh, he was out in the woods hunting. And he came on some tracks in the field.
Mm-hmm.
And he looked down to see what kind of tracks there was. And a train ran over him.
Isn't he the gooseberry fool?
Well, let's see what's in the old mailbox today. Here's a letter that comes from Mr. Bob Bradler, our safety commissioner here in Cornfield County, and he writes, "Dear Buck, remember, a lot of damage is caused by guns that are not loaded." Yeah, but not much more damage than old Junior causes when he is loaded.
I'll tell you one thing. They ought to pass the law to register jokes instead of guns. I'd hate to think what happened if some of these jokes fell into the wrong hands.
Hey, you know where?
What?
Junior's gonna join AA.
Yeah, he probably wants to find out what makes him hick.
Man, heard you and Misty talking yesterday, and you kept mentioning the word idiot. I hope y'all wasn't talking about me.
Oh, George, don't be so conceited. Do you think you're the only idiot in the world?
Hey, Grandpa, what's for supper?
Oh, ham hocks cooked in butter beans and kale mixed with collard greens and candied yams and rhubarb pie with a cold glass of buttermilk. Let me do that again.
Yum, yum.
He who hesitates gets bumped from the rear.
Here's Donna Fargo.
Funny face, I love you. Funny face, I need you. My whole world's wrapped up in you. When the road I walk seems all uphill, and the colors in my rainbow turn blue, you kiss the tears away, you smile at me and say, funny face,
funny face,
I love you. Funny face, I love you. Funny face, I need you. These are the sweetest words I've ever heard. Funny face, don't leave me. Funny face, believe me. My whole world's wrapped up in you. And when I hurt your feelings, as I sometimes do, and I say those mean things that we know are not true, you forgive my childish way. You hold me close and say, funny face,
funny face,
I love you. Funny face, I love you. Funny face, I need you. These are the sweetest words I've ever heard. Funny face, don't leave me. Funny face, believe me. My whole world's wrapped up in you. Funny face, I love you. Funny face.
She ain't as pretty as a spotted pup.
Hello, Annie.
Hi, Gordy. Do you have any sleeping tonic?
By golly, Annie, I got some of my old mixture here.
Do you recommend it?
Well, it's so good that we give away an alarm clock with every bottle. Tommy Cash.
There'll always be that one, always be that certain one. You may love a dozen, but matter it does. dozen, for there will always be that one. Up here you'll forget instantly, and a few you'll forget more gradually. A few may linger, one may wring your finger, but there will always be that one. There'll always be that one. Always be that certain one. Of one you'll be fonder, and in your mind you'll wonder what life would be like with that one. There'll always be that one. Always be that certain one. You may love a dozen, but matter it doesn't, for there will always be that one. There'll always be that one. Always be that certain one. Oh, you may love a dozen, but matter it doesn't, for there will always be that one. There'll always be that one. Always be that certain one. You may love a dozen, but matter it doesn't, for there will always be that one. There will always be that one.
Well, he's just cute as a bouncy.
K.O.R.N. Farquharson here with some of the obituaries as passed by in our town last week. As your Persian rug poet Omar Khayyam put in his quota, your moving finger has writ, and having writ, passes on to the awe wilderness with a jog of wine, a loaf of bread, and a thou beside you. This message was brung to you by your Hartley Broadbent funeral home, where all men are cremated equal. Miss Ignata Norrie, prominent spinster and clubwoman of town, was laid quietly out in a state last week at your Broadbent funeral home in First Orange. Many called and passed by to pay their respects, mostly members of the various organizations to whom she was joined at one time or another. Flowers come from your Grand Diadem of the Wayne and Star Southeastern Division, your Daughters of the Elk, your Minute Women, and sons and daughters of exempt fathers of your Spanish-American War. Always overactive in her group activities, either as resident president or recording vice, and now reading her minutes in the sky, I guess you might say that the dear old girl was more or less clubbed to death. The estate of your late Telford Battley of Yellow Dump was discussed here yesterday in reprobate court. Old Telf was found to have left very few effects. Friends of your diseased was not too surprised by this, for when you have no cause, there aren't too many effects. This is survived by the wife, who was Irene Simp, that was of Adolphus Town. Not the Simps that owned the bank. Her people was your poor Simps.
Way back in the days when you had a figure, remember the trip we took to New York? The menu was big, the prices were bigger. You asked for champagne and I popped my cork. Why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over and I thought I'd found true love. You met another and you was gone.
Hi there, friend. This time once again for Junior's Academy Award Drive-In Theater. All of the wonderfuls is brought to you by the Mr. Nice Guy Tonight's movies, an old classic, Mr. Carl Goshwins. And Goshwins is the meanest and biggest. He make King Kong look like Truman Count Tory with all of them our things else in mid. Let's all watch Goshwick. Roll 'em. Thank scary movie. Every time I watched that, I got scared my deodorant broke down. Now, I'll break down and call for a car. Remember, the number to call is BR549, and I had it out there all the time.
Radio may be old hat, but TV is old movies.
A man who proudly wears a brand new hat on his head is a happy man. But a man who wears a meatloaf on his head is a man who'll never go hungry. Ruined my hat. Luckily, I have a meatloaf in the oven.
I just ate it.
Howdy. Love of the food and all you that spend time in the kitchen. Grandpa, the folks are just in time for another one of our health food recipes, right?
That's right, dears. And what is the recipe for today?
Well, today's recipe is carrot pie. Mm. You know, carrots are great for the eyes, Grandpa.
I know that, darling, but rather than going to the trouble of cooking them, why not just apply them directly to the lid?
Oh, you're warped! Get out of my kitchen!
My wife's cooking makes me so emotional. Every time I eat her mashed potatoes, I get a lump in my throat.
Walking the dog, and I'm never blue. I'm a walking the dog, I ain't thinking about you. I don't need no one to tie me down. I'm a walking the dog, and I'm painting the town. Such an easy life I never knew, until the day that I lost you. Well, I'm a carefree lad that has seen the light. I'm a walking the dog all the day and all night. Until the day that I lost you. Well, I'm a carefree lad that has seen the light. I'm a walking the dog all the day and all night. Yeah, I'm a walking the dog all the day and all night.
Archie, I'm dog-tired today.
Well, that don't surprise me none. All you've done since you got up this morning is growl.
I'm complaining to the National Association for the Advancement of Canine People.
Here's old Cousin Ern and the whole gang.
Fly away, I'll fly away.
new salesman at the post office. What does he sell?
Well, he sells cosmetics for ladies and gents.
Cosmetics for men? I mean, what would they use?
He says he has a men's perfume that is guaranteed to get the girls. He says it smells like money.
Forever man teaching his son how to save money, there's women that's teaching her daughter how to spend it.
We are salute to my hometown, Mount Airy, North Carolina, population 7,325.
Salute!
Stand 6'8" when I'm completely unfurled, and to find a mate I've looked all over this world.
Then a store downtown advertised everything for us tall guys,
and they had everything except tall girls.
Oh, whoever wrote that song ought to write one more and then tear them both up.
Hi, poet people. Claude Strawberry here with iambic cheer. For those out there, roses are red and violets are wine. I know roses are red and violets are wine because I saw them hanging on the line.
All good marriages are made in heaven.
I reckon so. The ones I've seen made down here on earth sure ain't much to talk about.
I don't care what you say, Junior. Not all married people are unhappy.
Of course not. Just the men.
Here's Charlie Rich.
Thank you.
fun. Part two of Hee-Haw, Archie Gamble and Tennessee Ernie. Junior pays a visit to Pauline and Pierre. Jim and John Hager harmonize. And Donna Fargo sings her latest hit.
Now here's Buck and Roy and Pickin' and Grinnin'.
I'm a pickin'.
I'm a grinnin'.
My new girlfriend yet. Huh. She's 6 inches taller than me.
Well, Roy, that ought to keep you on your toes.
That's one way of looking at it.
Roy.
Buck.
At the square dance the other night, did you notice Miss Molly Kay's upswept hairdo?
I did, and frankly, I was wondering where she swept it up from.
Excuse me. Was you embarrassed at your first kiss?
Boy, Buck, I'll tell you, the first time I got kissed, I fought like a mountain lion.
I fought like a mountain lion?
I had to, or else she'd have gotten away.
This kissing business can really be dangerous. For instance, did you know that every time a girl kisses you, over 10,000 germs are transferred?
10,000 germs? Yeah. I don't care. Oh. Can you think of a better way to meet up with a germ?
Oh. Roy, I can't believe that you're planning to marry old Maggie Martin. Why, she's kissed every man in Tennessee.
Oh, tish, tish. Tennessee ain't such a big state.
What's wrong? Anything wrong?
What kind of cigar is that?
That urn is a golden peacock.
I thought I smelt feathers burning.
Now, kids, we're going to learn some arithmetic. If I lay one egg in this hand and one egg in this hand, how many eggs will I have? Jenny?
None, teacher. You can't lay eggs.
If that little girl don't think Minnie can lay eggs, I guess she ain't been listening to her jokes.
It's time once again for Pauline and Pierre, the continuing love story that asks the simple question, will a rhinoceros always charge? Only if he has a credit card.
Here, this is our long-lost son.
Well, how long has he been lost? Remember when we was playing hide-and-seek when I was 7? Seems like I recollect.
Well, I've been hiding in the closet for 11 years.
Well, I open that closet all the time, and I never saw you in there.
See how good I have?
How about another game? I'll count to 10 and you hide.
Well, no peeping.
It was nice seeing him again.
Yeah, he's a good boy, and he sure knows how to keep out of trouble.
Here's Archie Campbell in the barber shop.
Hey, there's Roy, boy.
Hey.
Hey, Roy.
Gordy, Grandpa, Junior, old string. Hey, Arch. You like riddles.
Ragweed in that pipe? Riddles? What's about riddles?
I said you like riddles, don't you?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
All right, well, I got one for you.
Okay.
If it's 30 miles from Fort Worth to Dallas, then how many young ladies would it take standing single file to reach from Fort Worth to Dallas?
Dad blame, I'll have to give up on that, and how many?
It's 30, stupid, because a miss is as good as a mile.
Yeah, that's just pretty smart, you know. Yeah, it's pretty smart. I'll tell you what I'll do since you're so smart.
All right.
I'll make you a little bet. You like riddles. I'm going to give you a riddle, and if you can't answer it, you give me a dollar. Then you ask me a riddle, and if I can't answer it, I'll give you 50 cents.
That sounds fair enough, since I'm about twice as smart as you are anyway.
Yeah. Okay, I'll ask you. You want to ask me first, or you want me to ask you?
You ask me one first.
All right, I'll ask you this riddle. What is it that's got 5 legs, 5 wings, but it can't fly and can't walk?
Golly, right off the bat he's got me.
Yeah?
I don't think I know that one. Here's your dollar.
Yeah.
And by the way, what is it that does have 5 legs and 5 wings but can't walk or fly?
I don't know. Here's your 50 cents.
The town I grew up in was so small, there wasn't even no place to go where we shouldn't.
Empty Arms Hotel, sir.
Now listen here, buddy. I ordered my breakfast up to my room 2 hours ago, and it ain't come up yet.
Well, I can't understand that, sir. I'll check with room service. What did you order?
2 dozen eggs, 6 scramble, 6 over easy, 6 sunny side up, 6 porch, 1 pound of bacon, 2 pound of sausage, 3 steaks, 1 gallon of coffee, 3 pies, 10 pound of hash browns, 8 waffles, 3 stacks of pancakes, 1 pint of warm maple syrup, 2 hamburgers, 3 loaves of toast, lightly buttered, and 1 cup of tea.
Room service has your order, sir.
Well, what's the hold up?
They're still writing it down.
Yeah, Junior was 16 years old before he found out you're supposed to unwrap a candy bar before eating it. No wonder they used to keep him up at night.
Hi, I'm Tommy Cash. Johnny Cash is my brother. And you know, everybody's always getting Johnny and me confused, except Johnny's wife, and except Johnny's kids, and except my wife and my kids. Well, like I was saying, hardly anybody ever gets me and Johnny mixed up.
Doctor, doctor!
Yes, Nurse Goodbody, what is it?
Doctor, there's a man out in the waiting room who says he's a kleptomaniac.
Good heavens, a compulsive thief. What did you tell him?
Oh, well, I told him he better take something for it. That's what I told him.
There's Roy Clark.
Oh, that's such a lovely song. It's just that it's so hard to dance to.
Have you heard from home lately, Strine?
Yeah, I got a letter from home today.
You did?
I'm going right next to my heart. Heart, heart, heart. Y'all know my folks, don't you? We had a good time up there, didn't we? Great. Let's see what it says. Say, dear String Bean.
That's you.
Say, your brother Bob stayed over in one of them hotels last night. Say, he went out to eat, and when he come back in, he got in the wrong room. And he had 2 old maids in there, and one started hollering, maid, maid, there's a man in the room. The other said, well, keep quiet, you run him out.
Son, why are you afraid of girls?
Why, I'm not, Dad. Heck, I can whip any girl I ever met.
I appreciate people who become successful despite seemingly insurmountable odds. Why, if I had a drink in my hand, I would propose a toast to every bald-headed gigolo in America.
Why, here's a drink.
I thank you. Salute. Wow, that was dynamite. A hangover.
The best thing for baldness is a nicely shaped skull.
Why, you lazy bum. What do you mean? I'm dependent on you.
Well, if I didn't hire you out to the neighbors now and then, you'd starve to death.
Not a Fargo.
Now there you go, picking on me again, pushing me to the very end, telling me to move another mountain. Well, just cause you can walk on water, that ain't no sign I can. You know your mama should have named you Superman. Superman,
Superman,
Superman.
Morning, guys. Hey, that wind's really something, ain't
it? Yeah, it blows so hard it blowed the gophers out of the ground.
Oh, Pop. Yeah.
The Hagers.
If I could just sit around making music all day long, as long as I'm making my music, ain't gonna do nobody no harm. And who knows, maybe I'll come up with a song to make the people stop the fuss and fight long enough to sing along, everybody.
I believe in music.
Music, if you know what I mean. People who believe in music are the happiest people I've seen. So clap your hands and stomp your feet and shake your tambourine and lift your voices to the sky and tell me what you see.
I believe in music.
Universal language, and love is the key to peace and hope and understanding and living in harmony. So grab your brother by his hand and sing along with me and lift your voices to the sky and tell me what you see. 'Cause
I believe in music.
Hee-haw salutes my hometown, Fordtown, Tennessee, population 148 and a half.
It's a near medical fact thousands of germs can live on the head of a pin. Now, how's that for a weird diet?
The doctor recommended that old Herschel Wayne Hale give up his city job and take up ranching for his health. Now he's got the hoof and mouth disease.
I just standing in the phone booth talking to my family. Roy and the sheriff made me get out.
You don't say.
Yeah, and he made my family get out, too.
Hey, I found four horseshoes this morning, Lisa. You know what that means?
Uh-huh. It means some poor old horse is running around out there barefooted.
What?
How come you drove home from the sawmill so fast yesterday, Grandpa?
Well, the brakes on my old truck was completely wore out, and I wanted to get home before I had a wreck.
I got it. I'll call a crop duster and clean them out.
There he is, folks, a good singer, Mr. Buck Owens.
When I was a little bitty baby, my mama would rock me in my cradle in them old cotton fields back home. When I was a little bitty baby, my mama would rock me in my cradle in them old cotton fields back home. Oh, when them cotton balls get rotten, you can't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from a Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. Cotton in them old cotton fields back home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from a Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. In them old cotton fields back home. We love the time we spend with you, to share a song and a laugh or two. May your pleasures be many, your troubles be few.
Good night, everybody.
We'll see you next week on
Hee-haw.